Hey, what's happening YouTube? Josh Tedder here from 6 months later, and today we get to do one of my favorite videos, another Google Home features update video. Now, since our last feature update video in January, Google has been busy rolling out new features. And in this video, we'll be covering several of them, including setting alarms with media and a brand new feature called routines. This is 6 months later. Now, before we get any further, I do want to point out that your mileage may vary when it comes to these new features on your Google Home devices. Currently, these features have rolled out here in the United States for the English version of the Google Assistant on Google Home devices, but that does not necessarily mean that these new features have rolled out to your Google Home if you're in another country outside of the United States. Sometimes Google does these rollouts simultaneously. Sometimes they don't. It really depends on the feature. So with that out of the way, let's go ahead and dive into what some of these new features are. And first, let's start with multiple Netflix profiles. Now, you've been able to watch movies on your TV if you have a Chromecast with the Google Home integration for a while now, but the one limitation with it was you could only have one Netflix profile with your Netflix account through the Google Home app. So if you invited a friend over and they told Google to watch something on Netflix, it would link that to your Netflix profile, and then Netflix would take into account what your friend wanted to watch when it suggests new TV shows and movies for you on Netflix, which unsurprisingly, a lot of people found annoying. Now, luckily, Google did roll out a fix for this with multiple user profiles on Netflix. Now, the way Google fixed this issue with the multiple Netflix profiles is by using Voice Match. So what it will do now is when you set up your Netflix account and select which profile you want to use with the Google Home will also use Voice Match so it knows when it's you asking to play a certain TV show or movie on Netflix and not your wife or your daughter or son. Now, even better if your wife, daughter, or son also have the Google Home apps on their phone, they can also set up their Netflix account and profile, enable Voice Match. That way, when anyone requests anything of the Google Home in regards to playing a Netflix TV show or movie, the Google Home not only knows who it is making the request, but knows which Netflix profile is matched to the person making a request. Next up, let's talk about alarms. You've been able to set an alarm on the Google Home devices for forever now, and even multiple alarms, but finally you can now set a media alarm, so you can wake up to music, a podcast, or even the news. So instead of waking up to the default alarm, like this, you can now wake up like this.
For NPR, I'm Jack Peer. Donald Trump tweeted again at Kim Jong-un, the leader.
Let's take another example. To set a music alarm, simply say,
Google, set a music alarm for 7:20 a.m. tomorrow morning.
All right, and what music would you like me to play?
It's a Beautiful Day by Michael Bublé.
All right, I'll play the song It's a Beautiful Day for tomorrow at 7:20 a.m.
Google also allows you to now set recurring alarms, so you can simply ask it to set an alarm for every day this week. You can also set recurring alarms with music podcasts as well as news. Here's an example of a recurring alarm.
Google, set a recurring alarm for weekdays.
Got it, on weekdays. And the time?
7:15 a.m.
Got it. Your alarm set on weekdays at 7:15 a.m.
Now, if you're ever unsure about what alarms you have scheduled, you can simply ask your Google Home,
Google, what alarms do I have scheduled?
You have an alarm called It's a Beautiful Day set for tomorrow at 7:20 a.m.
And then you can cancel from there.
Google, cancel that alarm.
Sure, canceled.
Next up, let's talk about a new integration with the Chromecast on your TV and your Google Home device, all related around the Google Assistant showing you information on your Chromecast TV. Now, for this feature, it's specific to weather. You can now get the Google Home to show you the weather on your Chromecast TV. All you have to do is make sure you have a Chromecast plugged into your TV and then simply ask Google to show you the weather. Notice you need to say the word show in the phrase, otherwise it will not display the weather on your TV.
Google, show me the weather.
Right now in Raleigh it's 49 and mostly cloudy. Today it'll be partly cloudy with a forecasted high of 54 and a low of 33.
And if you have a newer TV with HDMI CEC, when you ask Google to show you the weather, it will actually turn the TV on for you and then display the weather on the Chromecast TV. Finally, let's take an in-depth look at Google's newest feature for the Google Home devices called Routines. Now, my setup there was actually a little bit tricky because we've all actually been using Routines before and just haven't noticed it. When you ask Google about your day and it tells you what's on your calendar, gives you your commute to work, what the weather forecast is, and then plays the news, you're actually using one of the now 6 routines that you can access in your Google Assistant settings. Now, in simple terms, a routine is simply a command you give your Google Home, and then your Google Home device will do multiple things. Now, as I said before, there are currently 6 routines available to users. They are good morning, bedtime, leaving home, I'm home, commuting to work, and commuting home. Let's take a look at these in more detail.
Google, good morning.
Hi, Josh.
Good morning is a routine to help you start your day. Simply tell Google good morning or tell me about my day, and then the Google Home will be able to do the following. Take your phone off silent for Android phones only. Adjust your lights, plugs, and more. Adjust your thermostat, tell you about the weather, your commute, today's calendar, and today's reminders. And then it can play the news, radio, podcast, and audiobook, or some music for you. If you've got a great wake-up playlist, you can also have the Google Home play this when you say good morning. All you have to do is click on the gear icon to customize any of the routine actions. So for music, click on the gear icon and then type in the playlist you want Google to play. Next up, we have bedtime, a routine designed to help you, well, get to bed. Let's see how this routine works in real time.
Google, bedtime.
Okay, let's get ready for bed. Tomorrow in Raleigh, it'll be partly cloudy, with a high of 74 and a low of 56. What time should I set the alarm for?
7:20.
Alright, your alarm's set for tomorrow at 7:20 a.m. Good night, Josh.
Now, when coming back home, make sure to tell Google I'm back or I'm home, and then Google Home will be able to do the following for you. Adjust your lights, plugs, and more. Adjust your thermostat. Broadcast I'm home across all of your Google Home speakers at your residence.
Hey there,
Josh has arrived.
Tell you your home reminders. Adjust your media volume and then be able to play music, news, radio, podcasts, or an audiobook. Now the last routines involve commuting. For commuting to work, simply tell Google, let's go to work, and then it will do the following for you. Tell you about your commute, tell you about the current weather, today's calendar, today's reminders, adjust lights, plugs, and more, and your thermostat, and adjust the media volume, and then it can play music, news, radio, podcasts, and an audiobook. Lastly, for commuting home, just tell Google, let's go home, and then Google will be able to do the following for you. Tell you about your commute, send a text message to people letting them know that you're on your way home, read unread texts if you have an Android phone, broadcast I'm on my way home from all of your Google Home devices in your residence.
Hey there,
Josh is on the way.
Adjust your lights, plugs, and more, as well as your thermostat. Adjust your media volume, and then you can play music, audiobooks, podcasts, news, and music. So as you can see, the routines feature is quite an extensive feature add to the Google Home devices. Now, the only thing missing is the ability that allows you to create your own routine. Right now, it appears that Google only allows you to use the 6 routines it has created and that are found in the Google Assistant settings. I'd imagine later on down the road, or maybe even later this year, Google will probably open this up to allow users to create their own routines. Well, those are the main new features for the Google Home devices. Thanks so much for watching this features update video. If you like this video, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos like this one. Also, be sure to drop a comment below and let us know how you're enjoying these new features. Until next time, thanks again for watching. For 6 months later, I'm Josh Tedder.